This is Focus TV, straight to the point.
Well, this is the Morning Break Focus, and I am here with my lovely co-host, and we are talking today about procrastination, the trap that most of us fall into. In fact, 90% of people fall into this category of procrastinating their work. What? Procrastination. All right. So we see from the video that most of us are born with dreams, we're born with goodness in us, but life throws curveballs on us and we get down. But 90% of success is actually doing it, showing up and doing it. And today we want to tackle procrastination, know what procrastination is about, the effects, what makes us procrastinate. True. Right. Yeah. Okay, join our conversation through our social media handles: Facebook Focus TV Kenya, Instagram Focus TV _ Kenya, and Twitter @ Focus TV. You can also send us an SMS on 22644. The first point, the reasons of procrastination and solutions to the procrastinations. Number one, you tossed self compassion to the wind. All right, so we find here that most people are so hard on themselves. When you fail to accomplish a task, you beat yourself, you put yourself down, and this is not what you should be doing, because this encourages procrastination even more. So be kind to yourself, right?
Yeah,
we should try.
And actually, one thing to actually help solve with the self-compassion is actually you have to be kind to yourself. You have to tell yourself you're doing good, you're doing okay, that the pace you're going with is okay for you. Accept that you're human. Remember that you're human, so accept that you're human and be optimistic. You know, be optimistic, and rather than a negative critic, be your own optimistic coach. Tell yourself, I'm doing good. What I've done so far is good. I'm on the right track. I'm going at my own pace. I'm doing the right thing. I'm progressively doing good. Rather than telling yourself, by the way, be your own optimistic coach. And actually, even before you go to our next point, we can tell them like a few courses that most of us go through. So that can actually take us to the procrastination thoughts.
Yes.
So some of them include, you may tell yourself lack of energy, you may feel like you don't have lack of energy, or you're so fatigued.
Yes.
That can actually make you procrastinate.
Right. The other is stress. When you're feeling so stressed about stuff and you tend to procrastinate your important things, you tend not to prioritize what you needed to do.
Yeah. The other one is other priorities.
Right.
You prioritize everything else rather than prioritizing what is needed now.
So you go to doing the things that are fun, more enjoyable, and then you leave the important things.
I think this
is what most people do. You leave the hard things, and then you do the easy, and then
the
hard things,
and you leave the boring things behind.
And the hard things keep staring on you, on your face. All right, the other thing is unexpected emergencies. Okay, this one you can't help, but it also encourages procrastination. And you know, if an emergency comes along, you procrastinate. So the thing you can do is maybe deal with that emergency at that time, and then move to that thing that you had prioritized, not to other relaxing things, right?
So another problem or another cause can be trouble finding new ideas. I'm sure most of us go through the writer's block, the, you know, you're exhausted, so you just have the mental block, you can't think, you can't do anything at all. So that can be another reason for procrastination, because as much as you want to do a task, you find your mind is completely blocked. You can't think, you can't, you know, figure out the next step.
You haven't been successful in doing your other tasks, maybe during the past week. Again, be kind to yourself. Be kind to yourself. You are human.
Another one is you've been surrounded by negativity. Remember, we are always advised and told to mind the company you keep.
Right.
So if you're around negative company, you know, instead of us working, you know, you have people or company keeping on telling you, you know, no, let's talk, let's you know, do some irrelevant stuff, you know, let's not focus on our work, let's focus on motion and all that. So that's kind of another hindrance.
You are lacking confidence in what you do.
That's a big barrier.
Yeah.
That's a big barrier. So another one is you're working from the wrong environment. For example, back in our campus in high school days, you know, when you used to tell yourself that ata nikisoma ata kama there's music playing, you're good. Which, to be actually very honest, is nothing you're actually focusing on. You're just listening to music. There's so many distractions around. So if you're working in the wrong environment, you know, you're gonna be less productive.
The other one is unclear goals. Prioritize your work. Write a to-do list. This is going to make your work easier. It's going to make you do what you have written down. Write it down. Right.
So now back to our second point for the reasons of procrastination and solutions to each. You have learned to procrastinate through role models. Now, through role models are simple people like, you know, our parents, our elder brothers and sisters, or even our environment, you know, our peers and our teachers. So if you're around people who always procrastinate from day to day, you know, you'll pick up that habit. You know,
true.
Like, you know, when you're young, you should be told, show me your friends and I'll tell you who you are. So if you always surround yourself to people who tell you, by the Chapanyo story, Kesho, you'd also tend to emulate that character from them. So what do you think can be a solution to that?
I think you can mimic other role models. Well, first of all, it's to realize that you've gotten this attitude from having wrong role models in your circles. You can mimic role models who effectively do their tasks and they manage it successfully. So you can adapt new role models, right? The other reason why people procrastinate is when you feel like you're not going to be effective in that task. This is so true because you feel like you wouldn't have confidence in doing it. You'd rather push it aside and maybe think, I will work on me growing this area and then I'll do this later. But we have a solution for that.
Which for that solution, I think you can actually try learning a new skill.
Right.
If you want to learn a new skill because you think that the skill you already have won't be effective for the task, learn a new skill.
Learn a new skill, and you can also adapt a new language.
You can
tell yourself, I will learn as I go. Even jobs. When you get a job and you feel like you can't do it, you just do it and then accept that responsibility. Then learn as you go.
Also, give yourself more time. If for example, you're used to doing your assignments with 2 hours and you're feeling you're less effective in doing that task, give yourself tomorrow, give yourself 3 hours. The more time you have, the more relaxed you will be, the more effective you will be, the more productive you will be. So give yourself more time as well.
Give yourself time.
So we go to our next point is your bias against a particular type of task. For example, you're given a certain work, like let me go to the household duties that most of us can relate to. You know, most of us really prefer cooking rather than doing dishes, or you prefer cleaning the house, you know, as compared to, you know, laundry. So you find most people procrastinate when they're given a task they do not like. You know, if I tell you right now, Vicky, do the dishes, you'll be like, hell yeah, because you know you love doing dishes.
Yes.
But if I tell you do laundry, you'll be like, I'll do that later.
And then later becomes tomorrow, then it comes next week, and then you don't have clothes.
So what do you think a solution to that can be?
All right. The solution to that is you can try to challenge yourself and to challenge your mind. You can build yourself, talk yourself into doing that task. I mean, if someone else can do it, you can also do it. What do they have that you don't have, right?
You have to prove your biasness wrong.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes, you can. You can do that. All right. The other one is your time estimates are a little off. You tend to vastly underestimate how long it will take for you to accomplish a task, and then you underestimate how quickly you will be able to get it done. It's known as the planning fallacy, right? Okay, so for example, you're given a project and you give yourself 1 week to do a project that is supposed to take a month.
Yeah. that means
well, of course.
Way off.
Yeah.
That means you'll rush, you won't even research adequately, yeah. You won't take your time, you won't actually read through the points right. That you've actually researched, you'll yeah. Just be copying and pasting, yeah. You know, like almost 99.99% of students do.
Known as the 11th hour. Yeah. And most of us work with the 11th hour
that's
so much,
true.
And it's so
that's
sad.
Because, and also, yeah. For the people actually work on the 11th hour, you find 90% of the 11th hour crew, most of the times they end up failing or underachieving. It's only
true.
A few percentage that actually work on the 11th hour mm-hmm. and things work mm-hmm. out for them. Mm-hmm. So you mentioned a point about planning fallacy. Mm-hmm. So using that point, I think you can look for a solution with that. Mm-hmm. You can make a habit of starting earlier than you think you need to work on mm-hmm. completing a task mm-hmm. early. Mm-hmm. This might compensate for any deficiencies in time estimation. Mm-hmm. Then give yourself a reward for completing the task mm-hmm. early and on time.
Mm-hmm.
Because, for example, if you finished your assignments early, mm-hmm. now you have an extra probably 1
yes,
hour.
Yes.
You can watch a movie.
Yes.
You can now hang out with family. Mm-hmm. You can catch up on friends.
Mm-hmm.
But if you keep on wasting your time mm-hmm. on you know, probably social media, and then you're remembering at 11 p.m. that I have an assignment due yeah. tomorrow at 8 a.m., mm-hmm. it will be hectic. You
right.
will work late, you will
yes.
sleep late, you'll wake up tired in the
yes.
morning,
yes.
your day will be less productive, mm. you know.